What's up, YouTube? This is Brian Pfeiffer, MarketingMeathead.com. And today I'm going to show you how to reach the millennials through your marketing. All right, welcome back. So today we're going to talk about how to reach millennials, which is an important age group these days when it comes to marketing, since their buying power keeps increasing as they get older. And these people are different than the generation that was, I guess it was the Gen X. It was the baby boomers, then the Gen X, which is kind of my generation, and then the Gen Y, and now the millennials. So basically, if you want to reach this particular group, you got to kind of treat them a little bit differently, because they've been brought up in a world of cell phones and social proof and things like that. So instead of, just basically, you can't be fake to these people. You can't go and have poor service or a poor quality product, because it's going to be found out really fast and your business is going to go down the toilet. So one of the things about this group is they really do like to shop on their phone. Obviously, I think people have kind of figured that out today. As marketers and whatnot, we buy a lot of ads on mobile phones and mobile feeds and whatnot. But they also do like to shop in stores. So keep that in mind. A lot of these brands, you haven't seen those retail. Everyone was talking, 4 or 5 years ago, oh, the retail stores are going to be gone. And last time I checked, I walked into a mall this past weekend, and there was plenty of stores in the mall, and there was no open store. Bays where stores could go. They're all full. So, people are still going to the mall and buying stuff. I don't see that trend dying out in anytime soon. One of the things about millennials, too, is they tend to be very loyal. As a marketer, you need to know, they have to have a very personal relationship a lot of times with a brand. And you can increase that personal relationship by, having multiple channels, whether it be a YouTube, Instagram, Pinterest, those kind of things. When millennials interact online, if you have multiple channels that they can interact with, it's going to be more likely that they're going to be brand loyal to you. So that's one big thing when it comes to millennials is that interaction across multiple channels. They tend to be very environmentally friendly. One of the things that there's a big movement, obviously, I'm sure you've seen some of the Netflix shows. Our Planet's one of them. There's another one out there, This One Crazy Rock, I think it's with Will Smith, and all these series on Netflix and whatnot are geared toward the environment and saving the environment, slowing global warming, preserving animals, endangered species and whatnot. This is a big movement, especially with millennials. So if your brand happens to be part of that movement, or your brand is dedicated to something that's environmentally friendly, you're going to have a inherent advantage over other brands and whatnot, and likely the millennial people will tend to be more loyal to you because of that. Okay, so keep that in mind. They're huge social media supporters. You can find a lot of millennials checking out YouTube. YouTube's been blowing up in the last 4 to 5 years, even getting bigger. I think we're still in the infancy stages of YouTube. I think it's going to even get bigger and bigger. Snapchat is obviously a large place for millennials to hang out, and also Instagram, the stories and whatnot. They're very popular with the younger generation of people that are on there. Now, it's funny, I got a story about Instagram and Facebook. I was looking to hire a new guy, a new media buyer, and I said, listen, can you send me over your Facebook and your Instagram? And he goes, Facebook? He looked at me funny. He goes, that's what my mom is on. So that's just how the new generation looks at Facebook. But he was definitely on Instagram. He didn't really have a Snapchat. I think Instagram's kind of slowly but surely taken away Snapchat's luster. Basically, it's the same damn thing on a different platform with more followers, and it's connected to Facebook and their ad platform and whatnot. So in my opinion, I just feel like Instagram stories is the way to go. If you're going to put your time and energy into one platform, probably Instagram and stories, and YouTube if you're doing more how-to stuff that you can be found through search and whatnot, because YouTube videos actually stick for a while and you actually get a lot of traffic. I'm starting to see some nice increases in traffic from stuff that I've done 6 or 8 months ago, so it's really nice to kind of see some of those videos still performing okay. One thing that millennials do know is when you're not authentic. So you have to be authentic. It's too easy nowadays to leave a bad review. It's easy to go and check reviews. You got Google reviews, Yelp reviews, Trustpilot reviews. I saw a new one that came into my inbox the other day. There's Facebook reviews. people can leave a review anywhere. And if you're not authentic and your brand's junk, your service sucks or your quality's poor, people are going to tell you on that online, and it's going to be easy to find that out. So let's finish off here by 6 tips to reach millennials. Make sure when you create your content, like your videos, your pins, your Instagram stories or your Instagram feed, make it very like visual and make it very shareable. Okay, you want to have it so that people are going to want to take that and share it with their friends, put it on their feed, put it, show their friends on their phone. Anything that you would consider shareable content is good content for your brand. Okay, so keep that in mind. Millennials like to share. It's just free traffic for your brand. All right. You're going to want to add like user generated content to your platforms, your websites, your social channels and whatnot. User generated content is when, for example, I have a group of people that I'm taking out in a limo in Las Vegas for my Bachelorette Vegas, and a bunch of girls, they take a bunch of pictures partying it up at Magic Mike or in the limo, and they send that to me, or I get a hold of that picture, and then I take that picture and I put it up on the website or I put it up on my social channels. That's called user generated content, because you're showing the user actually enjoying the service or the brand or the product. Okay, that's user generated content. So that's tip number 2. Tip number 3 is provide an experience for the millennials. Generally, people, they like to try like new things, and they want to see like authentic stuff that like relates to your brand. And if you can provide a really cool experience for millennials, they're going to be more likely to work with you and stay loyal to you. So keep that in mind when setting up your services or your products. Make it some kind of an experience, whether it be maybe the packaging is, in a box, you open it up and it's just like a really cool packaging. That's going to be like an experience. People are going to like want to take that and like record it and show their friends. Okay, those are just some ideas on how to get to millennials. Number 4 is word of mouth. Okay, one of the biggest things that's been my driving factor of my business that keeps increasing year over year out here in Las Vegas is my referral business. When people start talking to their friends, they start sharing stuff on their social channels, and the referral business I get, I close about 50% of the leads. The internet leads we get, we close about 1/10 of the leads. Okay, so that just gives you an idea how important that word of mouth traffic is. So that's tip number 4. Make it easy for your customers to shop, whether it be getting a quote, whether it be buying products online. Instagram's coming out with more stuff now, so you can put your products online and they can buy real quick, easy shopping, couple buttons on the feed. Amazon's kind of the master at this. They made it really easy to shop and buy stuff and get stuff quick. That's big for the millennial group. So make sure whatever you are selling or service or product, you make it very easy for them to buy. Okay, that's tip number 5. And tip number 6 is millennials like contests and giveaways. So if you do a contest and a giveaway, make sure you put the word out around it, and that's going to really help build your brand and some loyalty. If you got some cool contests or some cool giveaway ideas, just giving away stuff in general, offerings to people, whether it be some kind of discounts and whatnot, millennials tend to eat that stuff up. So overall, that's the 6 tips about marketing to millennials. And if you want to take away something from this video, make sure you're authentic and very transparent in all your marketing, and that's going to go a long way to reach the younger generation. By the way, if you haven't subscribed and liked this video, make sure you subscribe, bang that notifications bell, like this video, and leave me a comment below if you have any ideas for marketing to millennials. I'd like to hear it. I am the Marketing Meathead. We'll talk to you later. Thank you.